Hi everybody, I'm Dr. Prakhyat and I want to share my story of how we invented the ring of light. I began my residency in the winter of January 2017 at the All India Institute of Medical Sciences in New Delhi. I was an enthusiastic resident and I was doing phaco emulsification every other OT day. My results were steadily improving and I seemed to be on a dream run. But my dream run was brought to a halt by one of my patients. She's an old lady who had 6x6 vision on the first post-op day. I was really excited for her, but my patient was sad because she complained that she could not open her eyes completely. Her complaint persisted even at the 1 week follow-up, and that got me looking for the cause. I couldn't really find anything that matched her symptoms, but negative dysphotopsia. Negative dysphotopsia was the culprit. My patient was interpreting the temporal dark shadow in her peripheral field as something sticking her eyelids together. Well, it seems plausible for an illiterate lady like her. Incidentally, at the same time, I was working on designing a monofocal IOL for compensating angle alpha and centration on visual axis. So we designed another experiment to analyze the cause of negative dysphotopsia. The gap between the iris and lens and the lens edge seemed to be having a complex interplay here. There is currently no consensus on the etiology of negative dysphotopsia, but robustly designed recent experiments have shown the ray tracing hypothesis as the most promising one. Another school of thought believes that the nasal anterior rexis and the lens edge have a causative relation to play in occurrence of negative dysphotopsia. As per the ray tracing hypothesis, we see that the light rays reflected by the lens edge leave behind a corresponding shadow in the nasal periphery of the retina, which is interpreted as negative dysphotopsia. Our experiments show the same results as seen. The anterior capsule overlying the nasal anterior rexis is the second most accepted hypothesis, with multiple clinical studies giving indirect evidence in support of it. Secondary reverse optic capture, anti-dysphotopic IOL, and laser capsulotomy of the nasal anterior rexis are a few of those. Currently, there are several proposed solutions with few cases or small case series supporting each of them and refuting some others. The piggyback IOL is the most widely accepted of these approaches. It requires minimal manipulation and does not require cumbersome explantation. However, it gives inconsistent results and has multiple interfaces leading to altered refractive status. Reverse optic capture after in-the-bag implantation requires a well-centered and precise rexis, has increased after cataract formation requiring yak cap in almost all cases. It is difficult to perform and has variable success rates. Anti-dysphotopic IOL requires femtosecond laser for precision of rexis, which introduces very high costs. It completely changes the current IOL platform and in their own study has a high incidence of after cataract formation. So, with the knowledge of the cause of negative dysphotopsia and lack of a reliable solution, we conceptualized our own solution, the ring of light. We designed an experiment to see how a ring-like device placed in the sulcus altered the behavior of light rays coming from the temporal periphery. And eureka, it worked magic. Our device is the simplest and most elegant way to address the two majorly accepted hypotheses for causation of negative dysphotopsia. It illuminates the nasal dark crescent based on the ray tracing theory and covers the anterior rexis overlying the nasal anterior lens. Moreover, edge enhancement adds to the advantage. Based on this simulation study, a prototype was designed and the ring of light was ready to light up the dark corners. Our implant is a centrally hollow ring of overall diameter of 6mm with a central 5mm hollow, plate haptics for sulcus implantation in pseudophakic eye, edge enhancement for lighting up the nasal peripheral shadow. It is universal in size so that one size fits all eyes and sizing is not required. It transcends all platforms and can be used with any IOL in the back. It goes in with a sub 2.2 mm incision, which allows us to use it as a preventive measure along with primary phacoemulsification surgery. Currently ongoing patient study started recruiting patients in January 2019. Already 10 patients have been enrolled and the results are 100%. All our patients had resolution of symptoms immediately post-op or did not report symptoms at all. Here, the ND ring can be seen illuminated through a small pupil from a temporal slit of light. Anterior segment OCT in the pre-op shows the IOL in the bag with the anterior rexus margin distinctly seen. The gap between the rexus margin and the iris is the cause of negative dysphotopsia. Post-operative ASOCT scan shows the negative dysphotopsia ring resting on the anterior rexus margin, occupying the space between the iris and the IOL. We believe that until now, due to lack of a reliable solution, we have forced our patients to live with a compromise, telling them that this is the best that could be done for them. That status quo must change now because we have got the ultimate solution. It is 100% effective. It does not require the surgeon to change the platform of IOL or cataract surgery that they are currently comfortable with. It requires minimal manipulation. It does not introduce any refractive aberrations, photic phenomena or glare. It can be used in community hospital settings with minimum equipment which is required for the primary cataract surgery. It is low cost and is very easy to implant.